Whatever I report that, I might answer by yes. For example, all of everyone here, I might answer that. Take here some of main tasks of our here. Weakness of MySQL, MySQL schema, MySQL backup recovery, and so on. So we basically will be ordinary data tasks. And this is our way of working. Basically, each service is managed by one. About 15 services are assigned to each area. So when a service is assigned to the area, we check details of new service information. We check how much PS is expected. We check diary data growth. We check data retention period. And about scalability, we consider shared configuration. And we check all of the queries of services. And the database server specification is decided by each area. So like this, one area manages many instances and many servers and many types of products. This considering those things. The next is our MySQL operation. We use Enterprise Monitor as MySQL Enterprise Edition. Enterprise Edition is 5%, Community Edition is 95%. It's almost a edition. And we have some reasons for implementing Enterprise Edition. I will talk about that. And the number of instances are over 4,000. And we have maximum threaded numbers of threads in one service. Maximum 57 number of shards uses in one service. This is percentage of MySQL project. The rest is percentage of one ERO. Right, so the current percentage. One ERO, MySQL 5.6 was more than 5.7. Currently, more than half is MySQL 5.7. So then we have many problems when operating with a large number of MySQL instances. For example, so in three instances are basically increasing and management is difficult. And there are many services. Different services have different MySQL versions. It takes a long time for manual operation. I install and execute SQL and change the schema. The communication cost with the developer is high. But due to the complex scaling configuration, it depends on security. So, in order to solve those problems, we improve by standardization and automation. For my step, I'm going to talk about standardization and automation. Let me talk about our standardization. There are no four products like telephone server we use only our four MySQL. And we have fixed MySQL with the same minor version for standardized. I mean no minor version upgrade except with the bug ones. But we might change from MySQL 8 because since MySQL 8 broken in the future and the big change will be added. For example, check the strength of the application and from running for the target, so, and the next, there is no complex MySQL application, such as replication of the task scale replication. All MySQL scale in the same high availability configuration. Then there are two avoid depending on the particular tool. Okay, next, about the integrated management tool called MondayDB Plus. This tool UI looks like this. I mentioned earlier, my scale instances are increasing every day. So we developed this tool for the purpose of investigative management of the instances. So this tool will manage all instances information and provide some function for operation, like automatic installation of the automatic upgrade and so on. And it also will bring to when the master is promoted as a result of the data. Next, our automation. This is a list of operations and we automate and we keep enhancing them day by day. When you talk about a couple of automation in this case. First, our automation is for MySQL. We install MySQL automatically by using Ansible. As you can see on the red, there are various steps in the installation of MySQL, such as installing and set replication and the tools and backup. So previously, those steps were performed by manual or by shell script. There was a problem with that. As you can imagine, the main problem is when it comes to fix and add new features, we always have to go back to the person to the script and model, which is not efficient for such a big team like us. So by using Ansible, everyone can easily change or add new features. Okay, this is another example of our automation, which is a private cloud based on OpenStack. We call it Beluga. So our search function is very quick. Therefore, the private cloud was developed to reduce server setup time. Currently, MySQL and Redis cluster and Elastic Search have been released as a service on our cloud platform. The server for MySQL is both digital and virtual machine. Recently, we launched a project for cost optimization by using MySQL on Kubernetes. Because there are many MySQL instances, it was necessary to use server resources efficiently. With Kubernetes, it is easy to scale up and down CPU memory at this time. Redis is threatful. As I mentioned earlier, this is about why we use the private extension. As you may know, the communication extension doesn't have support. By default, MySQL execute state changes using one thread per client connection. After my client connection to the server, execute statements. So overall performance is great. So thread could increase server performance by efficiently managing threads for large number of client connections. This is benchmark. This is benchmark wizard ID. I get it better. I use Sysbench to drive only, and this is the result of the testing by increasing the number of threads from 1 to 3,000. So as you can see the graph, in the case of threads 1, 3,000 is not at least TPS, right? It maintains high TPS. However, this is thread 2 off is blue line. TPS decrease gradually from the handle. This is one service that is set to. So do you know Line Light service? Is that also available in Taiwan? Line Light. Line Light is a service that works by broadcast by our users and network. In the case of popular programs, large number of sessions connected and updated in a short time immediately after the broadcast start. So before implementing this tool, we experienced a problem by crash running threads. So as a result, the service went down. So after implementing the tool, other problems are solved. So recently we have broadcast NVDA final in Taiwan market on Line Light. It was NVDA final. We recorded the highest number of traffic at Line Light at that time. So, however, we did not have any performance issues. The thread pool is good for Line Light work. But please be aware, so when you implement this thread pool, I recommend it to use latest MySQL because all the versions are some hard. Thread pool might be not good for your services because it is good for simple query and high concurrency. The next is about MySQL 8. Unfortunately, Line have not released MySQL 8 in our production environment. We are planning to launch MySQL 8 at the end of mid next month. And we have investigated for MySQL 8 by three members of my team. We will have to investigate because MySQL 8 has many features, about 250. So we checked a lot of new options such as encryption, server correction, server. So this time, I'd like to use the content we have investigated to use MySQL 8. Recommended in future. I introduced those things on the slide. In addition, at the instant group table session, I will record our operation for adding param before my schedule execution. This is benchmark results of GPS by difference of operation. We compare the paper 8 and before 900 AirShare is a default of my schedule. And the general Shibai domain. Also, Japanese version has been added since MySQL 8. So, the result is here. So, general Shibai domain is almost same performance as MySQL 8 before. But Japanese version is increased performance about 25%. So, therefore, we don't use Japanese version as okay, about new feature, instance border table. This is a very nice feature. The instance border table is an operation that border table sets the border table segment complete immediately by only changing the data dictionary. It supports some operations and the instance add parameters most important for us. Before the function has been released, before this function has been supported, changing schema of a lot of tables was hard for us. So, in area of MySQL, we have auto table in various ways. I'd like to introduce some operation for adding param and large table into MySQL 8. In 5.5 and earlier, we use medium line schema change as our first choice. If you are familiar with maybe you know, synchronized machines, right? The synchronized machines is a table structure that will be read, write by the players. So it was good for two for us. But there was a problem for high load. So you can adjust the load by some options by running. But there was another problem. It took a lot of time to complete the load. Now the second choice, put maintenance and run portable. It is not the best of the load. But stop. In MySQL 5.6 and 5.7, online DDM is supported. DML can be processed from time to time. But thread is in this way. So thread delay is stable. It's large. So we have to consider about without swapping service and no thread delay. Adding power. In creating grid, we use growing schema upgrade for adding power. For instance, growing schema upgrade is adding current to the table of threads first, and then add current to the table of master at last. It's more by online here. The method means execute all the tables on each instance without execution. The statements are executable first and then all the tables as part. Executable means to disable binary loading for the current system. So the statements are not executed. So you might think about this to occur replication error. Table structure is different between the thread and the master in this method. So actually it has this about the execution. So to avoid the execution errors, there are two things we have to check. Those are depending on the difference of binary format. First point, in the case of being optimal load, adding to anything other than the last part of the table will cause a repetition. Therefore, we have to have the last part. Second point, in the case of the command statement, a replication error occurs if inserting the statement in the input without specifying part. So I think there is no room for no such statement. So we have to care about the point. We also need to make sure in advance that there are no such statements when not related. Also, this statement analysis will help us to check those statements. The view is normalized statements is aggregated. Second is the row-based replication of the function. So this is, for example, I got a thread delay alert, and I log in my MySQL instance, and I check show thread status or show process is. So always show the leading event for the relay log before MySQL is released. So it is, I do not understand what was the activity of thread from the message of thread. For MySQL 8, this stage, applying part or change part. This means that makes us possible to understand what type of query is executed in area of thread. For example, delay in the in addition, there is in log those query log events. We can see the SQL statement at input parameter if the option is turned on. This shows the if context in 1 million. So, just when you execute this statement, apply. So you should turn on the option to the option. Finally, I talk about MySQL monitoring. And we have a bunch of monitoring tools for each database solution. The downside of downside is of that, we have often a lot of monitoring tools for one side. It is inefficient. So in order to improve it, there is a project called U1. This is the purpose of integrated monitoring for all products in one. The Digimon is a combination of 16 open source to real account vendors. And the main components are Grafana and Frontend. So we are available to reduce communication costs by sharing the graph with developers. This is how the dashboard looks like. We can select all of products here. Okay. The monitor screen looks like this. This is easy to see with unified UI. The first one is the Macro MySQL. Next is the Kubernetes. Third one is the remote. So this is the digital architecture. Sorry for some of the context and the Grafana. We use Ansible for deploying exporter. We use Elasticsearch and Observer and so on. So now we are developing new version of one by using Canvas. Finally, I want to introduce our real-time monitoring for MySQL made by Goran. I call it My Status Go. It is my personal one. So my status will get MySQL metrics and display. I think most sites have multiple shares in the multiple display. Right? So we want to check those instances. The instances metrics at one screen. So as feature multiple instances as a feature, multiple instances can be monitored at one screen. If you are interested in this tool, to check in from the market. My status will display EPS and first level cross result and so on. When you show detail, my status goal and the data demo as a test.
Down, you can see the switch to bring down the Have you guys tried assessing the use of serverless for, like, for example, like Aurora serverless using MySQL in your company at all? Yeah, it's an AWS service. So it's a serverless version of MySQL.
Yeah.
Have you guys been surveying it or using that at all within your work stack? But like any other serverless sort of, yeah, for database specifically.
Nothing. Nothing. Just an example. Nothing. before asking questions.
do you send message from user in MySQL? Send any message from user in MySQL?
Message from user.
Okay, so you can
send
all the things.
Spend a long time in the query. So,
那感谢各位姑娘的参与，那我们准备下个session，那如果说。